My name is Vahid Chitsaz, part of Elite Mastermind Group. Thank you for being here this morning. Go ahead and introduce yourself to everybody. Let us know where you're coming in from.
Absolutely. I'm Elizabeth Resnick from Happy, Healthy, and Hot. I am located in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. So,
awesome.
And yeah, and it's great.
So let's dive into it. I see your Instagram post. My question is, why is morning routine is very important for individuals and entrepreneurs specifically? And then I'm going to go follow up questions on that, because I think morning routine is very, very important, but I want to get your feedback on that.
Absolutely. Morning routine is crucial. And it's something I talk about all the time, both on my Instagram account, talking to everybody, or with any private coaching clients. So I just believe, first of all, Happy, Healthy, and Hot is the name of my brand. Yes, it's a cute name, but it starts with happy for a reason, because everything starts up here. So I believe in the morning, you need to start off with a really positive mindset. I really believe your morning routine really consists of three things. The positive mindset, that's the happy. So it's whether it's positive affirmations, visualization, journaling, meditation, prayer, or a combination. I kind of do a little bit of all of the above. That's the happy. The healthy is putting something healthy into your body. You know, how you start your day. And in 20 minutes, we don't have a lot of time to go into that, but I provide a lot of information on that on my site. So that's the healthy, putting something healthy into your body. And the hot for me is doing a quick morning workout.
So hold on, I got a question. So healthy is not some crackers and some coffee and run out of the door, correct?
No, not for me. No, I do.
All right, so let's assume that I'm like the busiest guy on the planet for stupid reasons. I'm busy.
Absolutely.
What is the fastest, healthiest that we could have?
Okay, Vahid, here's how I start my day, how I make it healthy. I don't eat right away because I am doing other things. So I have my coffee. It's organic coffee with mushroom extracts in it that help me focus. I add in some collagen peptides that give me specific proteins that are giving me better skin, nails, and hair. And so that's all good. And then I'll mix in some type of healthy fat. Also, because that gives it some staying power for me, helps my brain. And some will mix in some other things, like some superfoods, like turmeric, cinnamon, stuff like that. But again, you know, that's maca, some adaptogens. There's all kinds of directions you can go. But basically, I call it smart, sexy coffee, because drinking that organic coffee with mushroom extracts helps me focus. That's what makes it smart. The collagen peptides are good for my skin, nails, and hair. That makes it sexy.
So awesome. Okay. I just wanted to make sure, because some of us are extremely busy. We got to go out.
Absolutely.
You got kids. It's not like I'm a single guy sitting at home. My work starts at 10 in the morning. I could just, you know, wake up at 7:30. Like,
right.
That shit doesn't happen to me.
Absolutely. No. We've got stuff to do. We're busy people. And that's a lot of what my account is about. I show people what I do on a day-to-day basis to take care of myself and still have a life. And just to give you an example of how well this works, and this is one of those things where the timing is unbelievable here. So you and I set up this interview, what, a month ago, I think? Okay,
right.
I'm 53 years old. And on Monday, I started out I just found this out last week. I am in the Maxim cover girl competition. I am in the running to be on the cover of Maxim magazine right now. So that is what.
Well, I don't know who's running your page, but the pictures that I saw, he's not 53, looks like 23. So I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm running my own page. It's all me. But if anybody wants to go and vote for me, I'd be honored. And there is a link right in my bio. But yeah, I'm
awesome.
Running. I am number one in my group. And I attribute that to this healthy lifestyle.
So let's dive into it. Okay. So we got the morning routines. We got all that stuff.
Yes.
What do you do as an entrepreneur or someone who's running their own business on the self-development side? And what are some of the recommendations that has worked for you that you could share with us?
Like on personal development?
Correct.
Okay, absolutely. Well, one thing, I know you're big in the book, Think and Grow Rich. And there is so much good stuff in there. And it's really thanks to you that I'm rereading it. So
awesome.
I read this book back in my 20s. And I got a couple things from it. It did not sink in. I absolutely was not ready for it. And then like maybe 5 years ago, as I started getting more into personal development, I listened to it as an audiobook and it was okay. I think it's better to read it because I need that stuff imprinted into my brain. So my morning routine, what I've been doing lately is, because I believe reading and feeding your brain is so important, but it's hard to find time. So you know, I get up, I do the things. And for me, it's, I do a little like prayer, a little meditation. Sometimes I'll listen to a guided meditation that gets me kind of, you know, pumped up and powerful. I do some journaling, some gratitude. And then I will take a few minutes to do some reading. So right now that's the book that I'm working through. And I'm reading it and rereading it and taking notes, because you need to build these things into you need to build these habits into your day. So if I waited until the day was over and said, oh, maybe now, you know, maybe sometime today I'll have time to read, it's not going to happen. So that's why I like to just fit this stuff in.
So you reading Thinking Gorgeous right now, what can you share with us with what you've read in the past couple of days? What stands out?
I mean, the overall message of the book is that it all starts in here, and it's all up to us. And we are ultimately in control of our destiny. And, you know, there's so many different factors involved, but really that's the biggest message that I'm getting out of it, is it's all up to me. And I look at how, I think one of the keys to success is persistence. And that has been so true for me. You know, people have been saying to me lately, oh my gosh, you're blowing up. Like, I've been getting a lot of publicity lately. I was just on the local news. I'm in this Maxim thing. I've been, you know, an interview for a TV show in New York. I'm doing a lot. I'm like, I've been showing up every single day for 4.5 years. I started Happy Healthy Not November 2nd of 2015 is when I went live with my website, and then I turned to Instagram. So I've been doing this for 4.5 years. So yes, things are blowing up and it's amazing and I'm so grateful and I'm loving every second, but I just kept showing up. You know, I was consistent and I was persistent. There's days when I hear crickets, but I kept coming out here with my message. So that's, I would say, you know, it's that persistence, but it's also feeding that subconscious mind, because that's what's working behind the scenes.
And yeah, I think it's like you build your business when no one is watching. You put the good content, you do what you need to do, and you don't stop till that gets done. So I'm a big believer on that. I mean, listen, I had a hard time getting people on my live sessions when I started 2 years ago. Uh-huh. Here's the crazy part. Yesterday, I was talking to one of the coaches that he was like my first or second interview. And I went back and I looked at it. I known this guy for like 2 years and some odd change, 2 years and maybe 2 months or something like that. Or it's coming to 2 months. I don't know. But it's coming to 2 years, right?
Yeah.
So I've had a lot of meaningful conversations with him, and we have shared a lot of ideas. And I looked back and I said, wow, imagine in 2 years from now, what would I say with the rest of the people that I have interactions with? And I said, that was probably a good 20, 30 minute that I spent with him talking about the book, Thinking Grow Rich. He's a big fanatic and he's in London. He's not even in, you know, in US.
Yeah.
And that's crazy, because to me, that's like true self-development, because now we're having, so when I call him, I'm not wasting his time. He's not wasting my time.
Right.
It's not like, hi, how are you? How are the kids? No, that comes in the conversation, but we're like, listen, I'm working on this, you know, project. What do you think? Or he says, well, what do you think? We're sharing. Okay, talk to you later. Bye-bye. That's 15 minutes. I don't have those conversations with everybody. Like, I know that I value. So to me, it's like sometimes when, I don't know, it's okay if you hear crickets. It's going to pay off down the line.
Exactly. You just have to keep showing up. I mean, that's really, you know, my account, I think at first glance, people think I'm just sharing like health tips and, you know, workouts, and I'm prancing around sports bra and stuff. And it's like, yeah, that's part of it.
Well, I thought you were a model, so I didn't know you were sharing those tips. I thought you were doing modeling. So that's what I thought.
Well, thank you. My first modeling will be on the cover of Maxim. So I'm not a model. So, you know, think big. Anyway, you know, but my message, you know, it started out with just all these health tips, and that's still a big part of it. But ultimately, it's about just creating a life that you love, and that it's never too late to start. But you have to take action. All the, you know, you do the mindset, you do the subconscious stuff, you do the visualization, but then you get up and you do something. You make something happen. We get on this call and we have an interview. You know, you put yourself out there. You've got to do that part too.
Definitely. So here's my question. When you go through turbulences, challenges, you get punches in the face, people say no to you, rejections, objections. What are some of the methods that you keep going? What helps you keep going?
Okay.
Because not everybody can stay positive for that long, and we're just human beings. Things happen. What are some of the tips that you can say for young entrepreneurs?
Okay, I think that's an amazing question, and things happen all the time. Life isn't perfect. In fact, I think the more we up-level, the more challenges we're going to face. And, you know, it's just a testament to, you know, we have to keep going. So really two things that work for me. The first one is gratitude. I just take a moment and I'm grateful even for the bad things, because I know that they're happening for a reason. I know they're happening for my higher good. So as ugly or as hard or as frustrating as it may seem, I say, okay, thank you, God, angels, universe. I know this is happening for a reason. So that I put that out there and I'm just grateful. And I also think about the other things I'm grateful for, you know, just whatever, you know, it is. And then I love affirmations. So one that I use when things look tough is, I'm willing for this to be easier and more magical than I can imagine. I've had things that looked so horrible, problems that looked insurmountable, that I was like, how am I going to get through this? I use that affirmation. Sometimes we are just, it's like, let me look at this. I'm willing to see things differently. And I've had things that just looked like they would be so hard and they literally worked out magically. So again, it's putting that positive spin on things and looking at it, knowing it's happening for a reason. It's happening for your higher good. And maybe it's not as hard as we're making it. Sometimes I make things harder. I'm like, oh my gosh, I have all this stuff to do. And sometimes it's not as bad as it seems.
I agree with that 100%. You just got to push forward. I mean, if you look back, there were a lot of things that I thought it was impossible for me to do and then be accomplished. And I'm like, why didn't we make it so big of a deal? Like,
yes.
It was cool. Now, I'm not saying that there weren't some challenging times where me personally cussed everybody out. Like, I understand, like, you know, sometimes you're like, you're in that state and things need to happen. So you got to push forward. So here's my other question.
Yeah, absolutely.
For entrepreneurs, when they get into the business, in initial phases, they don't get much success. Absolutely. How important is it for them to have a mentor or coach?
I think coaches and mentors are amazing, and I've had many over the years. So first of all, you have to rely on yourself more than anybody. So you cannot think that, oh, I'm going to hire a coach and they're going to fix things for me. They're not. They're going to guide you and maybe speed things up for you and give you direction, but ultimately it falls on you. So I've done several things. I will work with somebody, like have my own, just be accountability partners with someone who's maybe at the same stages as I am in building a business. And we check in with each other weekly and we'll set goals. And that's wonderful, but it really needs to be the right person. So I've done that with people where they kept not doing their thing and it got unmotivating for me. So it's got to be the right person. And maybe it's right at a time, you know, for the time, and then one of you is moving a little faster than the other or something, and it's time to move on. And I've hired coaches. I'm working with a coach right now. She's phenomenal. And, you know, a coach can kind of see things that maybe we don't see, give us direction in areas where they've already had success. Ideally, there's somebody who's one step ahead of us, and they can pull us along with them and speed up the process. I am all about investing in yourself. It's not just investing money, investing the time, you know, in the personal development. It's also important.
Yeah. Money you can get back. Time you can't get back. So I think
exactly. It's
more investments of time in that, because, I mean, and it's work. I mean, self-development is not easy. Listen, it's not easy to call yourself out on your own shit or excuses that you're making for your life. Like,
absolutely.
That is not easy to do.
It is not
like,
easy to do.
Holding yourself responsible is not an easy task to do.
It's easy.
I see a lot of people giving a lot of excuses, and I'm like, you're not giving excuses to other people. You're giving excuses to yourself.
Yes, I've been there. I've made the excuses, certainly. I've said all the reasons, even before I started my business, all the reasons why I couldn't start it, why it wasn't practical, why it wasn't the right time, why I should wait. We all make excuses, but there's no perfect time. And you're right. Ultimately, there's just no reason to blame others. It's like, you're responsible for your part in things. So.
No, you said it already. You have to show up every day. You have to show up. You don't show up, nothing happens. Listen, I want to thank you so much. I'm definitely rooting for you. So I'm going to go check out that link and vote for you.
Thank you so much.
I hope everybody, how do people find you?
So they can find me on Instagram is the best way. I guess they can, you know, tap on this. It's happy, healthy, and hot_Elizabeth. And that is where I am showing up every single day, super active in my stories. You can see what I'm doing in my day-to-day life. Great motivation, inspiration, health tips. And I would be honored for anybody to vote for me and get me in the cover of Maxim, because I want to spread this message that you can create a life that you love. And that's what it's all
about.
Listen,
we're going to do our best. We're going to do our best. But if it don't happen, it's totally fine. There's the next one coming. If they don't do it, they probably made a mistake. It's a clerical error. They need to get their head right.
Okay, but here's the thing, Vahid. I've won just by being in the competition. Just by when I got that email saying you've been hand-selected by the judges, I've already won just by being here. I guarantee you.
That's great. You go, girl. That's it. That's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Thank you so much for taking this time and being with us this morning. Hopefully, we'll be able to do more. Thank you.
I would love it. Thanks so much.
Bye-bye. You got to talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.